New York City. It provides opportunities and the chance to expand a vision. This group of dancers face themselves, pregnancy, weather, and a huge new city to bring their dreams to a national level. In the spring of 2003, a group of dancers from Jackson, Mississippi, embarks on a journey to New York City. The name of the group? Polarity Dance Theater. The point of the trip? To be a part of Project Dance Times Square. This venture will test the company's character. Treacherous conditions will threaten a pregnant dancer, while others deal with personal disappointment.
I can get the hell away from me.
The journey starts in the heart of the Deep South, Jackson, Mississippi. Born here is the performance group Polarity Dance Theater.
Polarity is a contemporary dance company that wants to transcend all kinds of boundaries and borders with their art, whether age or geographical or race, whatever. These dancers want to really share what moves them. And we were able to take a number of them to New York City for this particular project.
Mark Aronson is the artistic director for the ensemble and the team leader. Abigail Chen is a charter member of Polarity. Her husband, Aaron Chen, has been dancing with the group since its inception. Andrea Brubaker joined the group as an apprentice before becoming full-time. Angela Jones has been dancing with Polarity for the last 2 years. Courtney Gurley enlisted with the company in 2001. Keith Williamson handles Polarity's technical arrangements. Michelle Painter is dancing as an apprentice. Yvette Kuntz is also a charter member of the group. Kevin Wu has joined Polarity from the People's Republic of China. Polarity Dance Theater was formed in the year 2001 and began by building repertoire and extending their performance experience as a group in and around Jackson, Mississippi and the Southeast. Recently, Polarity was afforded the opportunity to travel to New York City, New York for a performance in Times Square.
When you tell people that you're performing in New York, it's kind of like, oh my goodness, New York, because a lot of people associate New York as dance.
I think it's a great melting pot of people, a great melting pot of artists. I think that's what's such the draw of New York.
We've been preparing so hard, like for so many months we've been rehearsing, practicing, and for me it's been a really good time, and I feel I've grown a lot as a dancer, plus I've never been to the city, so I'm just really looking forward just to being there.
Courtney Gurley is 5 months pregnant, but will be making the trip anyway to be part of one onstage piece.
For me, I don't know where dancing is in the future. Like, I don't know how much longer I'll be able to dance now that I'm pregnant, what I'll be doing afterwards. So just the simple fact that possibly the last performance for a little while is in New York means a lot to me.
Camaraderie is building as the rehearsals for the trip have increased.
I'm gonna sue you for $50,000. Or we'll settle right here for $20.
On day down, 4-2. And faster, 4-2. And back, to the front, and around, around.
To prepare for this trip, we did have to think very carefully because we knew when we got to New York, the stage that we were going to be dancing on was so big by so big. And our studios that we normally rehearse in are vast. So we had to mark off the tape on the floor, the approximate size of what our performing space would be. And that was interesting.
Overall, ladies and gents, for the most part, you guys are really splatty out. You can't be so big. The movement needs to be large, but the center needs to be concise. You know what I mean?
We're just crashing into everybody. I just don't remember crashing in so bad yesterday.
As the trip to New York approaches, the choreography for each piece is refined.
So don't let the focus go over here and then over there. Keep it here.
Yeah, I've seen that vapor look around
everything.
Here. Dance is my life. Because
you're really right, Aaron.
Dance let me learn a lot.
Together. You're very close, so you should be able to feel each other's energy right off.
Not just about the body. Not just about the language, the dance language, and not just about the technique. That is how I love dance.
I pray that you would bind us together, Lord, in love and in the spirit. And we pray all this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Ready report. Today.
60. Oh, my. It's not going to rain. Guarantee you it's not going to rain.
40% chance of rain on Saturday.
It's not going to rain. I guarantee you it's not going to rain.
So on Saturday, we have a chance, 40% chance of showers, 59 degrees for the high. So it's going to be quite cool.
Should it rain and the stage be wet, that would be a big concern because it makes for a very dangerous situation. People could slip and fall and really hurt themselves, and we definitely don't want that to happen.
The group will leave Jackson on Thursday morning, fly to New York, and stay until the following Monday.
Andrea and Michelle were also looking for something different in the Big Apple.
The joke was that on our trip to New York City that Michelle and I were going to find some awesome guys.
We decided that my perfect man, well, we went over physical characteristics, which is like tall and skinny, the muscles, you know, muscular, British accent, blue eyes.
See, I think there's a perfect man out there for you.
For some reason, they've been kidding me and telling me that the guy that I'm going to find is the urban cowboy.
Let's do some pliés, people.
Really?
Mm-hmm. Grand plié, 1, 2, and 3.
I know.
And reverse the port over.
Good, good. Okay.
Thank you.
The company arrives in New York and is picked up by friends with whom they'll be staying.
Dude, Shea Stadium, that is so cool, Shea Stadium.
The most challenging aspect of coming to New York is definitely travel. We were invited to stay at a hotel in downtown, but finances and things like that, we weren't able to pull that off. So YWAM was very gracious to allow us to stay at their headquarters up in Smithtown outside of New York.
Where's my suite?
Where's your suite?
Your suite is right down this way.
Thank you so much.
As you can see, there isn't that much room.
The company members move in, adjust to the accommodations, and rise early Friday morning for class and rehearsal.
Ooh, the bed on the side.
I am very proud to work with Polarity. They're an incredible group of dancers. They're committed to the art form, they're committed to each other. They are a group of people who are willing to put the other person first. They'll drop anything to deal with a need, and whether that's stopping a rehearsal and not getting as much done as we wanted to because somebody just needs help, they'll do it because they understand that there are some things more important than having a rehearsal, and some days the rehearsal is the important thing, and that's what we do. And we just love each other. And that's a remarkable thing to find in the artistic community. It's a rare gem.
Well, I've never been to New York before, so I'm excited about that. And I'm looking forward to going into the city today.
Welcome to New York!
Welcome to New York!
Welcome to New York!
Mark and Michelle really want to go to the library because it has this, like, the biggest dance collection in America.
And this is the library with the big lions, or is it the museum?
There's two big lions out front.
The library is closed today, but we're coming back tomorrow. And you would think that it would be easy to find your way around New York with all the streets being numbered, but not quite so.
The group travels downtown to explore the venue for the weekend.
Oh yeah, new sales rose, 7.3% in March. Stronger NASDAQ, awesome!
We are in Times Square, the place where all of the advertising is, and this is where our stage is going to be tomorrow. It's pretty exciting. Dynamic place. Lots of people, lots of cars, lots of traffic. Noisy, lights. It's wonderful. It's exciting.
Times Square is really exciting for me because, you know, you're getting in there, and not only are we in New York performing, but we're performing in Times Square. You're going to be up and you're looking at this flood and this ocean of people, but at the same time, you're surrounded by all this multimedia. You're getting this big screen, this flashing advertisements, and the Dow and the stocks just keep flying by your eyes and by your head, and you're going, whoa. Anyway, I'm looking forward to that. That's what I'm looking forward to.
I'm excited about just performing in this city because, I mean, it's kind of funny that the first time I go to New York, I'm like performing in Times Square. It's exciting and a little overwhelming sometimes.
Polarity will be part of Project Dance Times Square. The event was set in motion after the terrorist attacks in 2001. This event has grown to include over 150 dancers. Other Project Dance events have taken place or are scheduled in several other large cities.
Basically, Project Dance Times Square is locking down Times Square, which is 44th Street between Broadway and 6th Avenue. We close down the street for 10 hours. We set up a huge stage that's a Marley floor, 4 foot raised, 24 by 20. We have dance ongoing from very early in the morning until it gets dark. And all the performances are really a gift to the city and an expression of whatever artist it is, whether it's tap, jazz, ballet, modern, African, hip hop. Inevitably, you're gonna get people from all walks of life and from all languages. And we find that dance has a way of speaking a common language. You can actually understand the dancing by watching. And so we just get out there, and every New Yorker who comes by takes something different away from it. We go out and talk to people throughout the day, and we share with them in detail what our faith is. And the dance has a way of really, really attracting people who might be interested in what this is all about. And so we're so happy to talk to people and share with them the message of the gospel of Jesus Christ.
After completing registration, the company spends time seeing more of downtown New York, including the Empire State Building.
Yeah, my urban cowboys waiting at the top.
You'll never
the man
know.
Of my dreams.
Kind of like Sleepless in Seattle. Anybody see that movie?
Okay, so the wait was how long? 45 minutes?
About 45 minutes, $11 ticket.
So
he said no.
The next best thing?
We're going to kiss it.
We're going to kiss the building.
Kiss the Empire State Ready? Building. This is dedicated to Sleepless in Seattle.
And finding the man of our dreams.
A train ride home brings the group back to their accommodations for the evening.
I need to hand off the music to Sam, and we need to organize three chairs and we need to organize three pillows. Take a little side trip to the library before lunch. That's kind of the plan. 8 o'clock class, sharp.
Wow.
Okay.
Being pregnant makes it a lot harder to dance. Can't get my legs up as high anymore, can't get them up in the back. It takes a lot out of me to, you know, perform and to give a lot to the audience. And even though I'm only in one thing, I'm just excited that we're here.
It's pouring and it's cold.
I didn't think that there was going to be rain today. There's still not going to be any rain because at least the stage is covered. Just didn't bring a raincoat.
Hey, Aaron, do you need a bag for wet clothes?
I do. Okay,
good. 2 minutes.
All right, thanks. I'm ready.
There's a steady rain, and we're headed into the city on our way to Times Square. But we're hopeful that the stage will be covered and that it might be dry.
The company makes their way to 42nd Street and Broadway for their first chance to survey the stage.
Very, very wet.
Yes, very dangerous, very slippery.
Everything is on stage. I mean, that is less than 24 across, and that's probably about 18 deep if we're lucky.
We just have to be careful not to kick the poles. We don't have to worry
But we don't have the corners, so we can't get out of the way even. It's totally wet.
Yeah, you'll be able to turn. You can whip out like 12 pirouettes on this one wet spot.
That's probably the worst thing, falling on a slippery floor.
Yeah, I think the scariest thing is the stage situation. Just because we've marked out the space and it's just not very big. And then to dance, you know, 4 feet off the ground with no wings, nothing to catch you at the edge of the stage. So that's definitely been a concern. Most stages that you perform on have wings, so when you exit, you have something to go off onto that people don't see you. But the stage we're going to be on is not only smaller, but there are no wings. It's just a drop-off, and you're just going to have to be very careful where you're going.
After checking the stage and costume areas, the trip to the library is on the agenda for some of the group.
So why don't we split then?
Let's go this way.
Go this way?
Let's just go this way.
I guess the thing that concerns me the most about the trip would just be being patient or being flexible. I think everybody has their own ideas about what they want to do when they're here because there's so much to do here.
This is the New York Public Library. It has a large holding of dance books and special collections for dance. At the moment they're having a Nijinsky exhibition. Really interesting. Let's go back. All right, let's go back.
We were going to see this dance exhibit at the New York Public Library, but it was moved to the Lincoln Center, and there are a couple of us who aren't exactly thrilled about that, but I don't think that everybody's really mad at each other. I think we're all just kind of in the zone, getting prepared for what they're about to do.
We went to the library. The dance collection is not there. And so, then, when I haven't eaten and I get disappointed, then I get really mad.
Food does help, especially chocolate cake.
After the library disappointment, the group travels back to face the stage conditions and prepare for the performance. The project dance schedule is divided into 3 acts. There have been performances all morning and early afternoon in the full day of dance. Polarity will present 5 pieces in the late afternoon and evening.
We got all our costumes out and got those prepared, tried to find, make sure we had everything that we needed. Didn't forget anything back in Long Island.
There's lipstick on that one, but I don't think there's anything that can be done about that.
We had some camping cots that had inflatable mattresses that we had a compression pump for. So we've had to blow them up a couple of different times, and then we had to carry them all down to the stage.
The wind is blowing it.
You can see my breath.
You need to help position the beds and the beds also. I'm trying to cut down the water on the stage.
We're good to go. Ready to roll.
I'm lost without you.
When it's raining and it's cold, a lot of things take place because when you're dancing, your body needs to stay warm, your muscles need to stay warm in order for you to attack the movement the way it needs to be attacked. If your muscles are cold, it just generally kind of restricts your movement, especially when you're barefoot. The rain and the mist of the rain gets onto the marley or the floor, and when you're on stage, you're still moving around because you want to stay warm.
The time has come for the first piece in the collection that Polarity brings to New York.
Of different people being in the same place or seeing a similar thing, I just really want them to walk away maybe different. And to think about things that they've seen and things that they've heard and maybe people that they've encountered that can talk to them a little bit about what's going on, and I just hope that they walk away knowing that there's something that intrigued them or touched them, that they were moved in some way. When you're doing a venue, a lot of times it's hard to get past the normal audience that would come and see you.
Jesus to meet every need. Now what's wrong with a withered hand? Why would Jesus be drawn to a withered hand? And I believe that same Jesus is present through the power of the Holy Spirit. I believe that. And I believe that same Jesus is present through the power of the Holy Spirit right now. Now what's wrong with a withered hand? Why would Jesus been drawn to a withered hand of a man that was in the synagogue? Now what's wrong with a withered hand? Why would Jesus right here in this room right now? And he wants to meet every need. Drawn to a withered hand of a man that was in the synagogue. Jesus Christ not only healed this man in the synagogue that had the withered hand, but I believe this very same story has a message for you and me, even down here in this year in which we live. Jesus knew all about that. They said, who can forgive sin but God? But God, but God, sin but God. They said, who can forgive sin but God? Then he said, take up your bed and walk, God. Then he said, take up your bed and walk. Forgive sin but God. Then he said, take up your bed and walk. Jesus coming. Jesus moved. Jesus moved about with divine appointment. Jesus is here and this place is packed and people standing outside. And Jesus walks in. Jesus always moved with divine appointment. And he had an appointment. Someone that had a withered hand, did he make it whole?
Here, I mean, in Times Square, there's just going to be people from all over. They may not even have ever seen a dance thing before. Just whoever's out on the street might happen to see us, and I think that that's probably the most exciting part.
Good. It felt really good. Like I think people understood it.
For the weekend of Project Dance, we have dancers from all over the country and essentially all over the world. And these dancers are coming from professional companies. They're coming from studios. They're coming from churches. And in every style of dance that you can imagine. And so really once everybody sort of gets together, it's an incredible show because, you know, while one company might be modern based, another might be tap. And so we sort of mix everybody up. And so the show is very entertaining. Thank you.
the people always want watching. What are you doing? Also, be a dancer. You not just use language to talk. So when I dance, just let the movement be a language, be real life, let the people to watching you. Then the dancer must to be catch every people the eye to follow you.
We're just gonna get ourselves together. Get out there.
Oh, this is not gonna stay.
Ears are glued on.
Anybody have an extra hair in it?
Once the performance started, it felt like it moved very quickly. We were spread out, which was great. We had about 3 or 4 pieces between each thing that we did. Although it seemed like 30 yards at least to our changing area from where we were actually performing. So though we had that time, we were running back and forth constantly. Total change of costume, total change of hair, adding more lipstick and that kind of thing. So throughout the day, it was very quick.
People walking by that would normally like even stop to look at stuff like that. I'm hoping that something will catch their attention about it, or something will be different about it that so they'll stop and watch it and be touched in some way. They'll see something beautiful about it.
Started here in New York City collecting dancers from various companies, whether it was Merce Cunningham, the Radio City Rockettes, Broadway shows, and then we trickled out and got dancers from Houston, Texas, and Mississippi, and Montana, Virginia, California, and the list goes on, and honestly, it was just an incredible representation of the dancers throughout the country and around the world, and hopefully that'll continue to expand.
Keith Williamson is handling the music, props, and scheduling for Polarity throughout the day.
During the actual performance day, our hardest thing was actually turning in our music. We were trying to find the stage manager, and we couldn't find him until about maybe a half hour before we had to perform, whereas everyone else had turned in their music. So that was a little harrowing. Another problem was trying to keep everything dry in the rain and making sure that people knew what was happening when and how many numbers they had to change.
I felt a lot more connected to the people that were watching, because I guess when you get on stage and there are lights and you're distanced, and a lot of times, you know, you can tell that there's a crowd out there, but a lot of times you can't see individual faces. It feels much more like performing. But I mean, in Times Square with people there in daylight and you can see individual faces, you can even see people's expressions. I felt much more connection with the audience and much more motivation for it to be more personal, like that I was speaking directly to them through what I was doing, not just performing a piece of choreography.
Extreme cold, extreme hot.
I think it went really well. It's a little chilly.
Praise the King! Praise the King! Let it rain! Praise the King!
To see what other groups and other individuals who are in the arts, and particularly, you know, in what interests us, you know, most, which is dance, to see where people are coming from and what they're producing. And, you know, there's so much diversity. We all have a common goal and purpose and a common art form and even vocabulary, but we're using it in a different way. There's room for a lot of diversity. It's exciting, it's interesting.
Michelle.
The last piece we did, the stage was really wet again. The rain had started up again, and it was a faster piece, and so a lot of shifts of feet and directions that could be really dangerous on a wet stage.
All right, okay. See me, babe.
Careful on the stage, might be a little slippery.
Thank you.
don't have lyrics that tell you exactly what we're trying to say. We want people's hearts and minds to have to think about it and really be provoked and have a really deep meaning with what we're doing. Purposeful theme or point or story to everything that we do. And we want people to see that, and we want to give them credit to understand that and know that without us having to throw it in their face, basically.
Inside the story, what can you see? That is how I love dance. Dancing is, it's from your joints, your heart.
The single piece that Courtney Gurley planned to dance in was not performed due to the tight schedule.
It's probably a godsend that I didn't do it with all the circumstances. I mean, if I'd slipped and fallen, that wouldn't have been very good.
It was great. It was wet, it was cold, but it was great. And none of us are hurt, even though it was very slippery. and great reception. I feel very good about this.
I got to talk to a few people to find out, you know, they're asking what it was, and I had an opportunity to share what the true vision of it was, and, you know, sharing the gospel with people.
We're such divas.
We've had our debut on Broadway. How could we not be divas?
Dad, my phone is roaming, so it's going to cost me like $50 bazillion a minute. But I wanted to tell you that we got finished dancing, and everything was a success, and God was really good, and we had a good turnout and everything.
The next day brings an opportunity for the group to enjoy more of the city, and the weather cooperates.
It's gorgeous.
We're getting to visit Ground Zero, and I think we want to take a peek at the Liberty Bell.
That's the Statue of Liberty, maybe?
See, they call the Statue of Liberty the Liberty Bell down south. B-E-L-L-E.
We're just spending so much quality time, you know, on a plane or in the dorm or, you know, on the train. Overall, the effect was to really unify us and draw us closer to each other.
He just said we're going to New York. We're going through Hyde Park, trying to get the accent down. I just want to land in.
There's a difference between uptown and downtown. Is it really up and down?
I think it really is
downtown,
down.
Like the city.
Penn Station, next and final stop, and have a good weekend.
We got Madison Square Garden, where the New York Knicks play. and then another tall building, and one more tall building.
The team is able to see the Statue of Liberty as they tour the city. The Manhattan Ferry provides a unique view of the business district. The group visits Ground Zero and takes time to reflect and to pay their respects. There is even time to find Little Italy and experience the culture.
Aaron is getting a pair of Oakley sunglasses, apparently for $8, which means they're probably not really Oakleys.
I guess for me it was all very inspiring. You know, you just get used to your part of the world, so to be outside of that just reminds me of the bigger picture about things.
That's her man, man.
I don't know if I should settle.
Handsome hunk. No. Rugged, long hair. Just kidding.
I think that I got a good balance of working hard, preparing, performing, and feeling like we did a complete job at that. But then also got to see Statue of Liberty, Ground Zero, Chinatown, you know, eat at great restaurants, all those things. The search for the urban cowboy. Well, I must say, I thought there might have been a few prospects. I mean, I have a better idea now of what I want, and I think I'm closer to it, but no definites right now.
For the performance, the reaction of the people, I believe it was very well received. Just the fact that people are willing to stand out there. You're in the middle of mass media, huge televisions all over the place, but we still had hundreds of people that would stop, sit there and watch the performance. And that just speaks a lot of what the people were saying, what the dancers were saying. That just captivated the audiences.
The solo right before appointment on through the tap, I mean, they ran the gauntlet of emotions, and that was exciting to see that the real people were really being affected by what was going on. That was pretty cool.
Just was really a community of dancers, dance practitioners coming together, so that was really cool. And then for me personally, I don't think I've ever felt so loved in my life by a group of people, and so it was a really special time for me. So what's next?
Polarity's never gone on a trip like this before, and this is breaking new ground for us.
We dancing in the ring look like the American song, singing in the ring.
Every time I go into class to rehearsal and I see those people, and they're my people, I love them. They are my brothers and my sisters.
So strong, the memory. So strong, the memory.
Grand plié, grand plié. Four, one, two, three, four, and one. Oh, two.
Run the jump of this man.
Sorry.
You're not supposed to be filming that.
That's cool. That's it. You're done from there.
Okay, one, two.
That was very impromptu. I'm unscripted. So.
You're not gonna give up, are you?
Hi, Bob.
I'm in Times Square.
I'm here.
Oh, I see what you're saying. Watch out. Sorry. I tried to warn you, but I didn't see it fast enough.
Testing. One, two. Oh, sorry.
There you go.
Is it okay now?
It's good, yeah. Okay. Well, one more.
Yes, definitely worth it.
Okay.
Nothing's sticking out?
A little
out.
More.
A lot of versatility. No, sorry, let me start over.
That's okay.
Oh, yeah, for her.
Well, it was just...
We tested and seen, you know, and this bad.
Okay. Fix it. Thank you, Micah.
You're welcome.
It's important.
Mission. We went through our arch and...
Thanks, Mr. Baumgars.
Didn't like that one as much as the first one.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
Oh, my God!
Damn, what a hot dog. Oh, I hope that's not.
That's not going to be in the takeouts, is it?